foremost, thank you very, very much for joining us. This is our first Urban Barn Workshop of the year. So lots of good things to come. And I always do a quick show of hands because I'm so curious. Who is this their first time here with us in the store? Ah, so well, some newbies. Welcome. Yeah. So our Urban Barn Workshops are really meant to help guide you, inspire you. I think we're all pretty ready for spring.
Yes.
Would you say?
Yes.
Bring it on. Yes. I know, it's fun to see all of the color kind of finally coming out. So we hope to be able to send you home with some ideas, some inspiration, so you can start setting your home up and bringing spring indoors while we wait for it to start blossoming outside. So before we get started, I'll just, if you haven't joined us before, we have some great prizes that you can win tonight. So first and foremost, if you had come in and signed up one of our ballots, this is going to go into a draw at the end of the night tonight, and you could walk away with $100 worth of Urban Barn product to take home with you. So if you haven't filled one of these out, don't worry, we'll give you another chance at the end of the workshop, okay? And the second prize, which is fab, is, does anyone here have Instagram? Yes. Okay, so if you take lots of photos tonight and use the hashtag on Instagram, Urban Barn Workshop, did I get that right?
Yep.
Thank you. So Urban Barn Workshop, use the hashtag, and you can enter to win a draw for a $200 gift card. So that's going to be drawn tomorrow, and that's Canada-wide. So the more pictures you post from tonight with the hashtag, you see my good side, you get entered to win the gift card, okay? So definitely take opportunities to take pictures whenever you feel like it. And just to give you kind of an overview of what's happening this evening, we're going to touch on four different categories. So we're going to start with mixing and matching your dinnerware. How do we start preparing for events like Easter and Mother's Day and bringing out some of those fresh colors that have been hiding maybe in our cupboards over the years, or we're looking for, you know, new fun colors to tie into existing plate and dinnerware. And then secondly, we're going to talk about how to use our fresh blooms. I think one of the reasons we're all here today. Where do we use these little pops of color? How do we create a bouquet? Where's the best place to use something loud and big and tall, or maybe something just a little bit more subdued or petite, or how to tie it in maybe to a table setting? So we're going to talk about that. And then we're also going to touch on textiles. So we've got a lot of lovely spring colors, as you can see, around the store. And we're finally seeing a lot of those loud blues and pinks. Kind of went a little crazy with the pinks today, but it is a color that we're seeing a lot in design and fashion, is this kind of blush tone. So we'll talk a little bit about how to layer that into your existing decor at home. I will open up after every segment for any questions, feedback, comments. I like to get a lot from you guys. What do you want to know about what we've just discussed? Maybe you have some input of your own. So I'd love to hear from you, okay? So don't be shy, and let's get started. So first and foremost, we are going to look at mixing and matching your plateware. So I'm gonna hold these up so you can see them. I know they're a little bit hard to see here, but I'm gonna show you four different looks. And I'm gonna show you the looks with a little bit of our foliage and how to disperse that into your table setting, and also how to mix and match it with the plateware you have at home, or maybe something that we have in our open stock that you can combine with what you have existing. So the first setup that I'm gonna show you is more subdued. So when I think about setting my table for an event, if I have a formal dinner or friends coming over, what's the mood that you wanna create? What are you doing? Are you having a formal dinner, or are you having brunch? So maybe you want to, you know, brunch to me is more loud and colorful and fun and playful, whereas dinner time I might want my tones to be a little bit more subdued and low key. So on this side we have very simple, just our clean, classic, beautiful gray with a crackle finish. So really lovely, and we've paired that up with two of our placemats, so we did layer those together. So you can kind of blend in. You could put a bright color in the back if you did want just a little pop here. Okay, so this is pretty neutral. And then my napkin, I've just tucked There's a lot of ways you can showcase a napkin, but this I've just tucked underneath the bowl. And then our wine glasses have this very pretty little bubbly gray, so that's tied in all together. And then if you were looking at this like it was a full setup on a dining table, this could be your centerpiece. So any vase that you have at home or one from our new collection, this one's particularly interesting. I like the offset little gap there and beautiful setting here. And all I've done is taken three stems and I've just bent the bottom so that they are at the right height. And then you just spread them out a little bit. And it's very delicate, it's not overwhelming. And it's just, this is very Vancouver spring, is it not? I can't wait to see those magnolias, they're gonna be gorgeous. And then just a little bit of sparkle. So if you put some tea lights in here, they're just gonna reflect beautifully. And then you have a very simple, neutral setting. Okay, I'm gonna switch this up and I'm gonna do that very easily just by changing the centerpiece and the plates. So, if I take out, and I'm going to use my base plate. So imagine this is kind of your neutral whites or your just sort of plain solids at home. That's your base plate, that's your dinner plate. And I'm going to throw in something interesting. So then this becomes a bit of a mix and match. We were talking earlier today about what kind of things might we have at home that we often forget about. And there's so many of us that either have maybe mom's china or something really special that we put aside and we never use it. Because we feel like it has to be out for a formal event and we have to do the full spread with the silver and the fancy plateware and everything has to be presented from that collection. But what if you just did a touch of it? So you just brought out one of the small entertaining plates or one of the mugs. So just a hint of that. I think it's really important to showcase, you know, your prized possessions, but use them. Why not, right? Okay, so we take out our glassware as well, and we switch up for these really beautiful cut recycled glass. And then we simply add in a very modern candle holder. And we have a very different look. So this speaks to me, it's more like your tapas. It might be a little bit more casual. Maybe it's your, you know, kind of weekday setup, shall we say? So quite like that. And all we did was change, not the dinner plate, but just the feature setup and the glassware. I have about three different sets of wine glass and tumbler, because I'm crazy about my dinnerware. And then these were just, they can be any sort of candle holder you have at home, right? But this is a pair. So have fun, play with it, but this blended really well together. We like? Yeah. Cool. Okay. So I'm going to shuffle over to kind of the real spring inspiration. And over here, what was drawing me to this setup was the idea that this time of year, everything starts to feel really light and fresh, and we want to bring some of our foliage inside. So what I've done is actually blended some of our outdoor elements like this beautiful concrete, well, it's really a candle holder for patio, but isn't it gorgeous just as a centerpiece? And then same, we've sort of just used these concrete decorative pieces here as part of sort of your table setup. And interestingly, I'm a big fan, and I'll show you two examples, of taking our basic foliage and kind of breaking it down, either cutting it or bending it. You're getting crafty, so you don't have to use it as just one big stem. It doesn't have to stay in its existing form. You can manipulate it to kind of use it in different ways. So in this scenario, I took this beautiful piece that used to be just a big old sprig. Okay, so he's quite tall, and we'll show you, we have him in another example. For our bouquets, but this is how he comes. So this is how you would buy him here at Urban Bar. Now if I take this home and I'm doing my little spring setup and I want to do just a really fresh centerpiece, but I don't want to go foraging, which I totally do, by the way. ask your neighbors or do it in the dark. But there's all sorts of pretty branches that start blooming this time of year, and you just take little clippings, you can kind of mix them in. But anyways, this is a really pretty setup. So all I've done is just taken the branches, and a lot of them just have wire running through, so you can manipulate these and really wrap them around whatever objects you've decided to use. Can everyone see this okay? Don't be shy if you want to come up and have a look. So maybe I'll just take this out of the way, just for a quick moment. Better? Okay. And then you could really, if you have a big setup, you can spread that the length of the table. If it's a round table, this would be just enough to be in the center. And then for our plateware setup, I just chose a very simple approach. Just the pairing of the like and like. These are very pretty. And just a soft, subtle blue and green, so a nice transition into spring. And then our tapas bowl on top. And then another little idea, just to tie in just a touch of spring with your foliage, so your fresh green. I have taken, don't have an example of it up here, but it's a big spray, so it's a big, long, yellow foliage that we have here. And I quite literally cut off a stem of it and I wrapped it around our napkin. So you wouldn't be able to do this with, you know, a soft, delicate, true flower, but you can do that with the silks, which I think is great. And then you just tuck that in the bowl and you have a very simple, delicate, soft spring display, which I think is very lovely. You could tuck a real one in, but I like this idea. Use it as a napkin holder. Do we like? Yeah. Okay, so the next setup I'm going to show you is just a really, again, just a quick transition. So to do that, we're just gonna change out centerpiece only and mix and match plateware again. A lovely display. You've seen better days. Did to start with for my inspiration was I just took this little jug and it's so cute, and I'm sure we all have some sort of watering can. You could use a small watering can if it's delicate and pretty, or a small jug. So the example that I'm using here is just get creative with what you're using as your base for your bouquet or for your centerpiece. It doesn't have to be what is typical. It can be something really interesting and different. So again, I deconstructed some of our foliage and I just took a few of these lovely flowers here and tucked them. And I think that's it's an extension of understanding what you can do with one of these. This is what that started as. Mm-hmm. Okay. So looking at this, you may think, well, I can only just use that in a big vase, and it has to be big, tall, and beautiful. But you can actually take these pieces and turn them into something really small and delicate. So just an extension of what you can do with the lovely silk. Okay, so I am gonna switch out our dinner plate for this beautiful blue. Gonna go a little pink for Mother's Day. Seems to be the theme. So this is the mix and match pair, which is a really lovely contrast, the blue and the coral. And then our sweet little delicate tapas bowl. And then you could even switch out for your coffee mug if you are doing brunch. You probably want Lady of the Manor for Mum. Tuck that right here. We also have Lord of the Manor for his. You can have either or. And very quickly, we have have a very different look. It's very spring, it's very fresh, it's very feminine. Let's go. You ready for Mother's Day? Cool, hey? It's so easy. That's what we're here for. So, questions for you. I have shown you how to deconstruct some of our beautiful silks and turn them into something different. Does anyone else do this at home? Do you have any ideas to share, like how you can kind of get creative with some of these pieces to use in your dinner or plate setups? Anyone tried it yet? Been so brave? No? Yes. Oh, this is true.
Put it in a glass.
Yes.
That's cool.
Beautiful. Yeah, yeah. We've seen this at weddings a lot. Yeah, so what you're saying, you'd have a very tall sort of glass cylinder vase,
yeah.
And then you can ground the foliage. Sometimes it's an orchid through the middle or something like that.
The stem
yeah. Yeah. And then if you fill it with water, you can float candles on top. It's very pretty. That's a great idea. Thank you.
Yeah.
I love that.
It depends on how they're constructed, though, because some of them, you know.
They won't take to it, yeah, fair enough. Yeah, you wouldn't want a really spongy one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You don't want to have an expensive one.
No. Well, depends. That was the intended use, but... Anyone else have any ideas? Yeah, that would
help. Sometimes I have extra foliage. Just when I have extra, I'll not decompose them, but I'll use them as petal all through my table. So the splash of the color here and there.
Yeah.
More color
the better, yeah. And what we were speaking to, we're going to talk about that when we move into our blooms, is every space in your house has a moment, right? So each room that you walk into, if you're not totally open concept, is going to have those little moments. So you can have different colors in your home. It doesn't all have to be all pinks or all blues or all grays. You can have those little moments and that's okay. Idea? No? Cool. So we're going to move along to our blooms. Are we excited?
Yeah.
Want to see how we can bring spring home. Oh, I did just want to add, this is just a side note, our Montreal trays come in a wide variety of colors. This is a really great way to ground your centerpiece on your table. If you don't have a lot of color to add in, this is a great little pop. And then you can use this around your home, you know, on your coffee table or as your breakfast in bed. So these are really great to use for just about anything. Okay. How gorgeous is this, by the way? Big fan. Big fan. Valerie, can I get your help for a second? No, we're all good. I'm just going to start grabbing these guys. If you can. Actually, sorry, hon. If I can get you to just move these out of the way for me, and then I'm going to start pulling from over there. Thank you.
It gives you more room. So you can just put them in and put them in.
Shopping with us recently, you've probably seen we have a lot of silk flowers in right now. And I just wanted to share, I don't know if anyone has a memory of their first time ever buying or experiencing using silk flowers. Does anyone remember the first time? For me, it was always Easter with my mom. So Easter would be coming, and I'm from Winnipeg, so the flowers are at least another 3 months away. You know, the only thing you can really do to bring foliage or fresh bouquets into your home is to go and get silks. So my mom and I would go out, and we'd shop for different bouquets and baskets to bring home, and we'd fill the house with color and silk flowers. So for me, this time of year is, I mean, I love fresh flowers, don't get me wrong, but silks are a great way to add those touches around the home where you can't necessarily get that from your garden just yet. So, we just wanted to show a wide variety of uses for the foliage, sort of how to, if you're less is less or you like more is more, where do you start playing around? How do you pair these together? And what are some of the rules of thumb? So the first thing I'm going to show you is something very tall. Oops. So when we think about spaces like your entryway, your mantelpiece, or a corner in the hallway, a lot of our clients say, well, I need something tall, like big. It has to fill the space, right? So back in the 90s, that was sticks, right? Everyone has had sticks. I will take the bundle of sticks, please. Yes, I'm gonna put those in the hallway. So some of us have moved on, but I totally still have my sticks somewhere in my closet. But this example is just a blend of two different styles. We've kept it pretty neutral. You certainly could change this out seasonally, but it's nice to have something that stays pretty static with the season. So just a really soft green and the neutral pussy willow, which is very, very beautiful. This could be deconstructed, and you could leave these, you know, in fall if you just wanted to pair these up with something, you know, a little bit more low key and kind of bring it down a little bit, add in your oranges, reds, darker greens, whatever for fall, or even Christmas time. These actually look quite pretty at Christmas as well. So you get a lot of height here. We have a nice tall vase. And then if you were so inclined, you could put sand or rocks and really raise the whole thing up even further to get a couple of feet out of it. So entryway, hallway, mantle, this is a really great idea for giving height to any space. And for this particular style, I would say two styles or two colors maximum, and keep it pretty neutral, because this is something that's probably gonna live in your space for quite a bit of time. It should be kind of blend in with the decor a little bit more than your focal point or your centerpiece that you change out more frequently. Anything to add to that?
I could use it if you have a big fireplace that the tile goes or the brick goes all the way to the ceiling, and sometimes you just need an accessory that has a bit of height that would work, or a corner, because every corner should not be left alone. I think when you go into a house, it's like a treasure hunt, you know? So make sure that you have a little spark somewhere, everywhere in the house, and I think, yeah, that could work with a big high fireplace or a corner near a window, an entryway with a big staircase. You know, sometimes there's that curved stairway and there's nothing. Mm. You don't know what to put in that.
Totally.
Yeah.
An empty space.
Yeah.
Then you might want something a bit more substantial for the vase as well.
Love it.
Thanks, Val. Okay. Our friend number two here, he's kind of funky. So, for this example, we wanted to show you shouldn't be afraid of mixing and matching and going a little crazy, right? So don't be stuck to the idea that you'd have to do, you know, five of the same. You know, if you want a little bit of height, throwing this in here, this is a very clean, sort of all white, modern. You might put this on your countertop or your island. You know, you could go on your coffee table or your console, or your entryway. And he's just kind of wild and funky. So we've just mixed two. And in fact, I think we only have one single stem in the middle. So you could bulk that up and make it a little bit more kind of substantial at the top. But it's really fun, it's different, mm-hmm. right? To get creative, don't be shy to, you know, try new things and put different things together. I kind of love that idea. All right. This one is one of my favorites. Designed by Miss Valerie over here. So this particular bouquet or centerpiece would be best used where you don't want anything to obstruct your view. So more often than not, that will be your coffee table, right? So in your living space, if you have something really grandiose on the coffee table, it's gonna get in your way of being able to move around the coffee table, sit on the sofa, see your friends who are sitting next to you. So low and full. is the idea when you need to be able to see the space around. So in this case, we used, again, just two different styles, and we kept it really bulky with the hydrangeas. Are a great way to add a lot of fullness. So they have a nice round top, and it only takes, I'll show you with three of these. You already have a really lovely center. So rule of thumb, I don't know if you agree, is in odd numbers for foliage. So you want to do 3, 5 and outwards from there. It just tends to give nice balance to the overall look. So we do quite love our hydrangeas, and these come in a wide variety of colors and do sell out very quickly. So we often find midsummer we're looking for more, and they go quite quickly in spring. So snap them up while you can. I am going to sidebar on that for a moment. I meant to mention at the beginning of our session here, but I'm sure you know, if you don't, we're running an amazing accent promotion right now. All of our accents are 20% off. Okay, so that's everything in the store except furniture. So that is all of the foliage we're showing today is 20% off. Our pillows and throws and all of our dining pieces, quite literally everything. So you're gonna have an opportunity to shop after we're done here. Take advantage of that because it's only on for a couple more days. Okay, so just side note, I forgot to mention that, I'm sorry. So yeah, just kept it really simple. We used the blue vase and then tied that in with a little bit of a hint of blue in here, just to kind of connect the vase in. I loved what you told me earlier, that design is a equation. And that struck me, because it is, if you think about an equation, you have to have balance. You're looking for a little bit of color. If you have in a chair or a throw a little bit of blue, you don't have to go blue all the way. You just need to balance it with something in that same tone, or you know, grouping of blues somewhere else in a picture frame or a tray or a throw. So it's just about those small moments, right? I quite love that. I think I've made a mess. Beautiful bouquet.
It looks good, all messed up too, so that's the beauty.
Oh, good. It's organic and natural. Love it. Very pretty. And one of my personal favorites was this gem. Isn't that lovely? So this is really showcasing where you can blend. We have 1, 2, 3 styles here. Keeping within sort of, this is mauve, right? So we've kept within our color story, and then we've just remained very fresh with the additional color here, just the white, really simple. So you can mix more than two. Two is not the rule. Just be mindful of the families that you're choosing from, so that it doesn't look over the top, but you can certainly blend as many styles as you like. Is that just three? Yeah. The other rule of thumb is just about, and with all things, when we're setting up vignettes, foliage or anything, it's the balance is in your triangle. So if you were setting up something on your console, you're gonna have a tall item and likely two shorter items. You might stagger it. Same goes for your foliage. So you're gonna wanna start tall, and then have a nice balance around it, so you're kind of building down into your pyramid. So something like this would be great for entryway, your console with a big mirror, a couple of candles around it. Certainly could use it on your dining table. When you're not entertaining, or I don't know how many of us use our dining tables every single day, I certainly don't. I eat on the sofa more often than not, right? Not alone, okay. That is a great space to set up a vignette, you know, as a stagnant sort of beautiful invitation to another moment in your home. So you can leave your beautiful bouquet right in the middle of your dining room if it's really only going to get used, you know, a couple of times a week. Or if you're okay just kind of placing it out of the way every time you go to have dinner at night, that's fine too. It is nice to have something there, so quite like the balance of this one. So that being said, we could show you all kinds of different options. What do you guys want to see? Maybe I can get some feedback. What inspired you to come out today? What would you like to know about putting blooms and bouquets together? Maybe we can show you something.
You know, mine is kind of a housekeeping question, but I live in a quite a busy street and my place gets quite dusty.
Yes.
So how would you clean the blooms and how often?
So very carefully, just with just a Swiffer. Honestly, I just take mine and I kind of just brush off the leaves. Certainly don't want to use any water or wet cloth unless it's a sturdy enough petal for you to be able to give it a wipe. More often than not, if you do it regularly and there's not too much dust buildup, the dust shouldn't get too sticky and it should just kind of brush off. Or you might be able to take a vacuum with the brush end. Without actually touching it, it might kind of take some of the dust away as well. Yeah. Yeah, you're welcome, for sure. Good question. Anyone else? What do you want to take home with you today? Other than literally maybe some blooms. Has anyone been struggling?
Know.
Yeah.
The vase is at the back.
Yes.
The blue at the bottom, does
yes.
that come with the vase or was it something you put in there?
And are you looking at this one?
Yes. Yeah.
This is the vase itself. Isn't that pretty? Yeah, so it's a nice frosted piece, and you do have the blue that's built right into that glass. Yeah, it's very lovely. So regarding vases, when you are thinking about putting a look together, if you're starting with a vase you have at home, I just have three examples to show you what you may want to consider before you purchase your blooms. So in each one of these scenarios, you have a different opening. So in this opening, we might be constricted to just a few pieces, but we're gonna want it to be nice and full so it can either fill out the top, or if you're going with, like we had in this example, this was a very narrow opening as well, and we just stuck with some very delicate sprays, which filled the area nicely. It didn't feel too bulky or overwhelming, but I wouldn't have been able to fit much more in that space without it being really awkward. Or something like this, where we have quite a wide opening. If you have a lot of tall stems, they're going to flare. And then you're gonna end up with a lot of spaces in between. It's like when you drop spaghetti in a pot. It just disperses, right? It's a good trick. So in that example, something like this, we can do a few things here to make that make more sense. We can shorten the stem so that the blooms sit closer to the neck. But I'd probably want to fill this with some heavier foliage so that I have balance, but that I don't have too much space in between the stems of the piece. So, nice fullness to the tops. So to measure where I want to bend, I'm just going to see where does the base of my foliage start, and then underneath the vase, that's how I'm going to get how much I want to bend it by. Okay, these are very pliable, so that looks roughly here. That's okay. Probably go just a little bit lower than that, so I'm just going to readjust. And that snugged it up really nicely. And then we'll do the same for this guy. Take a guess at that. I feel like I'm drowning in flowers right now. It's a good thing. Okay. Just gonna make it so you can't see me anymore. Alright, so I'm gonna do, that's my three. And because I want three, five, or any odd number over that, I'm gonna start putting my smaller bits of foliage and just see what happens with. Yeah. I'm just kind of using what's close to me here, but colors seem to be quite lovely. And the other thing with foliage, you really want to make sure you're flapping. If you bring these home, they're going to be really tight and stuck together, so pull them apart like a Christmas tree. If you've ever had a faux Christmas tree, you really need to flap those branches so it looks nice and lovely. So that's four. And see how I'm starting to fill this general area? Just by tightening the stem and then flapping, I'm starting to end up with enough fullness around the neck at the top. So that's six. See that okay? What do you think? Do you think we need, what do we need? Do we need another one of these big guys? Do we want some more of the cherry blossoms? What do you guys think? What is it missing?
Maybe one of the smaller ones?
Smaller ones? Because these are quite significant, right? So without being too overpowering. By doing that, I've also filled the center. So now some of my cherry blossoms are right up through the middle. And I probably just want to play with the branches, spread them out. I can't really see it from the front, so I don't really know what it's like over there. Approved? Okay. Great. We can spread these guys out too. So you kind of get the idea. If you're starting with something that's quite wide, you want to make sure you're selecting foliage that's going to start filling in those gaps. So something like this that's just mostly stem with a droop to one side isn't going to do much in the center. So what are we going to pair it with to kind of fill those areas up? And then similarly with the medium sized neck and quite a tall vase, if you have something like this where you've got a very short stem, he kind of just looks like he's wearing a helmet or he just has a little bobblehead or something. So this is probably not the most suitable foliage for this vase. So you want to think about pairings. Which vase am I using? If it's one of ours and I'm putting that together for you here in store, we can really play around with our options. But if you are looking at, or you can think of something at home you want to use, then you definitely want to keep that in mind. What's the balance? Where is the foliage going to sit in relation to the vase? How tall do I want it to be at the end of the day? Where is the vase going to be living, for example? Is it on the coffee table? Is it on the console? Is it on the island? And then how wide is the mouth? So how much can I actually fit in there without choking it? Okay? Any more questions? Tell me more. What do you want to know? Jake, you're formulating a question for me.
Yeah, like I'm thinking for my place, I want like a lot of green. Like I really like this one and and the one on the end.
Yep.
And I do like pink, but I'm not sure if I want like a
pink.
Yeah, I want more like dark
just
greens,
a small touch.
Light greens. But
so in that case, you can have a pair. So where do you have this? In mind for the coffee table, or sorry, did you say?
Well, I think I need like one for the dining table.
Okay.
and or the hall, like the opening. Okay. Yeah. So I think that one might be good on the end.
Yeah. Do you want to have your splash of pink in both areas? Or are you okay with it just being maybe as the welcome? Right?
Yeah.
So that's your splash of spring.
Just one, yeah.
So in that scenario, I wouldn't feel like I had to add pink into both. Maybe separating if you don't want too much pink and some of the pink foliage is a bit overwhelming. Having just a touch, so maybe, you know, just the cherry blossoms alone would be enough for the entryway because they're very, very subtle. You get that fresh green and a little bit of pink in here. That might feel a little bit more doable. And you could have those just on their own. That's okay too. You can have just one style. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. If in sort of, you know, splaying it out, we have a few examples of that in store. When you're walking around, if closer to the front of the store, you'll see our yellow. They look like the cherry blossom. They're a very small, delicate flower. But those have been spread out and they just have a beautiful splay to them. They look gorgeous on their own. So you can just have one and that might be just enough if it's just a delicate touch of pink. So
okay.
That's an idea. And then maybe in the entryway, you can use maybe a more loud pop if you just had, you know, two or three of the hydrangea styles together, or even just one in a water glass. I do that all the time.
That's nice.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Just a short water glass and one little stem, or sometimes I'll cut up a few tulips. So just like two, kind of tuck them in there. Little delicate touches can be just enough of like, oh, it's a reminder, like spring's coming. That's nice. Right there. It's not in my face, but yeah, a little bit of sunshine. Exactly. Great question. Yeah, does that help?
Yeah, that's good. Thanks.
Okay, cool. I just want to make sure that you're, you know, having the opportunity to tell me what you're hoping to hear tonight. We often present, you know, our thoughts for you, but we love to hear feedback too. So, how's your change?
I think
otherwise
great.
I'll move on. Yeah.
Yeah, just the mixing
okay.
and matching, like when does that happen?
Yeah.
You know, just kind of pulling in bits from different styles and how it looks. And like you said, get creative.
Get creative. Don't be shy. Yep. Show your flair. Show your flair. Okay, so that's all I have for you for blooms. We're going to move on just to a couple other notes about just glassware, dinnerware, again, for entertaining, some of the events coming up. Then we'll speak a little bit to textiles, and then I'm going to let you guys shop. How's that sound? And we'll do our draw, of course. Can't forget that. All right. Come out from behind the bushes. So, I know we spoke to this already, so this is going to sound a little awkward, but moving into patio season, entertainment, we're going to start eating indoors, outdoors, we're going to start hosting a lot more kind of spring events, again, Easter, Mother's Day coming up. We have a very wide selection of glassware, so we just want to quickly speak to some of the different styles we have, what you can use them for, what they're best used for. So, for example, if you're doing backyard patio, the recycled glass is a beautiful way to just do just even a lemon water. It looks gorgeous in here, cucumber mm-hmm. water, sangria with a straw, right? Why not? I'm a big fan of the big vino tumbler. Again, this beautiful recycled glass. All comes from Italy. It's gorgeous stuff. Yeah. But that could also just be fresh juice. You've got your little grapes on there. Could be for anything. This gorgeous little tumbler, he's nice and sturdy. So this is where you're going to feel real safe just, you know, having this on outside rather than maybe your big delicates that you probably want to leave inside for the season, right? So we did want to just, I'm going to pass these around so you can kind of feel the weight difference between them. It's kind of good to know, you know, if you don't mind passing those around. Think about what do you have in your current collection? Is it going to be suitable for the upcoming events that you have? And similarly with these two lovelies, this is a gorgeous piece. It packs quite a bit of weight. So for me, this is best used special occasions, but definitely for outdoors because it's quite sturdy. Whereas my wine glass, gorgeous, little touch of blue as well. I probably want to leave this inside, so I'm going to pass that this way. Just feel the weight difference. Yes. What do you like holding? Does anyone like kind of the old European style for wine glass? The stemless?
Yeah, I like
it. Yeah. So these lovely short rocks glasses could be used, I mean, they're water glasses for sure, but you might want to use, you know, your stemless for outdoors, great too, for wine. So with no stem, they're not getting tipsy-turvy. They sit right where you need them to be. So these are quite lovely as well. I'll pass that one around. And then just because we are talking about foliage, as I mentioned earlier, one of my favorite things to do is to use a beautiful, just simple water glass and a couple of tulips. But you can do the same with silks. I didn't cut these. I'm going to try to get you to visualize, but if you were to use this beautiful wine glass and just cut two of the ranunculus and stick them in there, how simple is that? That can go on your coffee table on top of, you know, a couple of books or beside a candle holder or just in the entryway. So simple is good sometimes. So that's, I hope that showcases sort of what that's supposed to look like. So you can do that with any glass. That one would be one of my favorites, but you could even use it with the jar as well. Mm-hmm. It'd be super cute. Yeah. Interesting, the difference in weights, hey? Where did the other two? Are they circling around as well? Oh, right here. Thank you. Can really feel the difference, hey? Mm-hmm. Especially with those two. The teal glass. Now that packs some weight. Yeah, big difference. Yeah. And again, these are 20% off right now until next week Monday. Okay, so that includes all of our stemware and diningware. May I? I'm gonna sleep over here and I don't wanna cut over.
Good idea.
Yes. Last but not least, we're going to talk about textiles. Yay! We love textiles. We've got some gorgies. I'm going to have you touch them because I've got foliage all over my hands. With the green hair. So, we really kind of went nuts with the pink. I'm sort of laughing now. You guys are probably thinking we're like obsessed. We're pink obsessed right now. It's funny because I'm not a big pink person, but when all of these soft pinks started coming out, I went, oh, yeah, no, I can do that. It's beautiful. And a lot of our clients have walked in and go, I would have never thought I was into the pink, but it's good. So, a couple of things regarding layering, and we talk about that a lot. You, of course, have your existing pillows and throws. You have things that you use every day. So without having to start from scratch, how do you layer in new and keep it fresh seasonally? I would recommend, first of all, kind of looking at what do you have out right now, what feels like it's a little bit more subdued or heavy or winter, and maybe it's time to pack that up. So if it's your really dark grays, your heavy moody things, your thick wools or your faux fur, it's probably time to take those out, store them away. They'll come out next fall again when we're ready to get cozy. And then that'll help you decide, okay, what are the gaps? So if I've taken out, you know, a little kidney pillow and I've got this great linen-colored neutral, what do I want to pair with it? And you can start just by even one or two pillows. So this lovely coral, you could mix and match this coral pattern with the geometric. So on either side of the sofa, then you've got a great little pop of color and you've only added in two pillows. Let's say you added in, you know, a little frame off to the side on your coffee table. Those three touches have just done enough to almost transform the feel of that space. It doesn't really take that much to make a really big impact. Similarly with throws, we often think of throws as just being kind of your comfy, cozy, they're only good for fall or winter, but there's great throws for spring and summer as well. They're lightweight, and these gray colors, they're quite thin, so you can use them just to snuggle up on cooler summer nights, and they're a great way to just, again, sort of drape over the side of the sofa. I'm so scared to touch this bright white. Thank you. So if you had this lovely throw on the left, draping over your sofa, and then our very pretty coral on the other side, that's all you need to do. And then with the soft pinks, you could go real girly and add in our gorgeous Mongolians with this blush color. Again, just an easy fix. You've got two or three items and you've made a big change.
How do pink and the dark coral work well?
That's lovely, yeah. Lovely, lovely, lovely. And you can't not see the ombre. Isn't that gorgeous? I can't get enough of this one. I love it. And then with your blooms that you're going to go home with as well, that can be your little touch. Yes. So sweet. So, small touches, blooms, a little throw, a cushion, little hits, whatever color you wanted to bring in, small moments, that's all you need. So we showed you the pink. We're just going to show you the soft kind of periwinkle blue. And that's just behind us here.
Did you want me to follow you?
Sure, come on over. I need someone to touch for me.
I can do that for you.
Thank you. So this look over here, we have used a lot of the sandy tone. So this, we're starting to think of the beach. Thank goodness, it's coming. Mm-hmm. Get down there sooner or later. So just adding in, changing out a couple of your picture frames on the side table or the coffee table or your entryway, pairing it up with lanterns. So lanterns are becoming quite popular now that we're moving into patio season. But don't forget to bring them indoors because they're so darn cute. So they can move in and out. Again, texture is really big. So with regards to mixing and matching your pillows, you want to think about texture, pattern, starting with, you know, kind of your larger pieces. If you have a great, lovely Mongolian that has just a ton of texture, you probably want to pair that down with something a bit smoother that might have, you know, a lovely pattern to tie in the color. Those look lovely together. Mm-hmm. You could use this set of three, quite large. We've got a very loud, lovely, fluffy texture here. It's just a tone-on-tone little pleat, so that's just a lovely detail. And then the pattern to bring it all forward and kind of make a nice connection. And then your lovely throw on the other side. And your blooms. Mm-hmm. We can't forget about those. So just nice neutral. Again, you wouldn't have to mix and match too much. If you want to keep it really neutral, you can just go neutral. You don't have to add in a lot of color if your color is already in your textiles. Mm-hmm. Right?
Mm-hmm. And it's a special bloom would be good with these.
Yeah. Again, just a lovely little bouquet. This is one stem. Isn't that awesome? We've got three that are knotted together here. And just alone, I'd probably do at least three of these. I mean, that's going to make just a delicate little bouquet just to start. Isn't that nice? Cool. All right. So, I want to open up the floor just to any final questions, queries, curiosities. Anything that you'd want to know? With spring coming, all kinds of other good stuff.
Oh, that was great.
No, let's get to the prizes, Kara. Yeah, we want to win some stuff. Cool, well, I just want to thank you so much for your time. It's always a pleasure to see everyone come out and show interest in these workshops. It's really important for us to make sure we're connecting with you guys. So these are really special nights for us, and we hope to see you again and again and again. Again, it's the first one of the year, and we will have many more to come, so keep your eyes out. We're always changing up the categories and what we're talking about. So if you have any feedback for us, also let us know what we're doing great, what we could do better, because we want to hear from you. Has everyone filled out the ballot, or do I need to hand out a couple of those? Right? If you want to come up, I'll actually have you draw for me.
Okay. Do you want to just say goodbye to Facebook?
Thank you, everyone on Facebook. Have a great night. We'll look forward to seeing you soon.